To me, this is one of the few days that I am very, very happy because I had this dream of wanting to teach a group of young people who will carry not only our traditions, but who will come forward and create a new tradition of, I choose the word, Sri Lankan. That is encompassing all our people and meet today's demands. We had great days. We go to Anuradhapura, Polonnaruwa, Sigiriya, and then we talk about our greatness. But what are we now? Third world failed country. The people who can elevate our status are artists. So we thought it is our duty to foster and care and bring forward talent that will even surprise us. Because one thing I have traveled a lot, I have lived a lot outside Sri Lanka. I have found people living, Sri Lankans living in England, in America, in various other countries, who have done very, very well. Now, what they tell me is, I say, what are you people doing in Sri Lanka? Now, they have gone to, say, in America, during the 70s, they lost their tea estate. It left it only 50 acres, which is not profitable to run. So there they went and worked hard, taught their children, and today they are citizens of maybe America, Canada, UK, who contribute a lot to the country they live in. To us today, the poverty is not only material poverty, but intellectual poverty. So, I thought to myself, how can we bring a new generation with knowledge? Art has many facets. Now, for example, a diamond is just a rock. Until it's cut and polished, a brilliant has 64 facets. So just imagine a new generation of young artists who has many facets, who know about dance, who know about music, who know about theater, who know about cinema and the technology behind cinema video and things like that. And I don't have to tell you, technology keeps changing every 2, 3 years. That, I mean, more than the fascination, it is rather difficult to keep up with. So, I had to have space to teach. Then there should be a guarantee of funds. I mean, we had to pay resource personnel. I tried many people. I mean, there was no single individual who would come forward and say, look, I will fund the whole program. And I had decided from my very young days that I would not work with the state. State means government, government means politicians, politicians means you become a catcher by the end of it. So I have decided, I have never worked. So, I tried to harness various socially conscious people who promised to help us. But I couldn't find the space 3 days in the week to teach, mainly Saturday, Sunday, and another day. So I went as far as Kurunagala. I wonder whether you are aware of that Janakala Kendra at Kurunagala. It's a beautiful place. Spacious, has everything that we need. So now, to start with, I couldn't go and ask funds from anybody. I spent my own money and advertised, booked the place, and we had about 100 people recipients to advertisement, and then we auditioned them. I'm sorry to say, there was only one girl who had that kind of talent that was worthy of even considering. The others were, if one gives marks from 100, they're all around 35, 40 at most. So I mean, so it is tragic. So I said to myself, all right, call it a day. You have wasted some money, you have wasted your time. So we stopped it. Then I tried to, with my good friend Palipana helping me, try and initiate a program at the Singhal Institute. There we had other problems. They have, they are bugged by the word Singhal. And I had problems because to me this whole project, although we are Sinhala, most of us, but we are not into a Sinhala traditional movement which will go for, you know, into the next generation. So I backed from that. Then as the last resort, I met Mr. Mohanlal Guerrero and said, look, you have a foundation, you are doing various things for the community. Now this, I consider, is very worthy, worthy of your trouble, worthy of your resources, because we are talking about a new generation of artists, performers, thinkers, you know, I mean, look, today, 20 years ago, who thought Mr. Thissabhya Sekara will be one of our best script writers? He had this bug of wanting to be in cinema, and then he joined Leicester. And then look at how he, instead of marking time as a director and making commercial films, or shall we say, money-making films, he became a serious filmmaker. So there are very few people that I would like to take out 2-3 hours of my time and speak to. One of them is this sir, because he's very knowledgeable. Now the knowledge he has acquired, collected, and then he has become such a, I mean, great writer. So the many facets makes him great. So is my friend, Ravi Bandhu. Ravi's father studied with me under Chitrasena, Guru Chitrasena. He later on worked for Guru Chitrasena as a costume designer, stage set designer, poster designer. And I must say, I'm dancing today because of his father. I saw his father's poster, and that moved me. So now I have been following, accepting in the rest of the world. Classical ballet, post-classical, modern, understand. So you see now, the same I could say of Kolita Bhanu and Soumya Nandi, the future generation. So it is, you know, I am a traditionalist. My base is classical tradition. But then I am conscious of the new generation that is coming and the new technology that we can face. It's dovetailed, it's married, so you can't separate it. So we have to have a new generation that understands art forms and technology. Vinim Basa working? Oh, then දැන් මං කි මම පටන් ගත්තා වගේ මගේ පසුබිම තියෙන්නේ පාරම්පරික පසුබිමක්. ඒ කියන්නේ මගේ පවුලේ කවුරුවත් නැටුවේ නැහැ. නමුත් මම අවුරුදු 14 ඉඳන් නැටුම් ඉගෙන ගත්තේ. නර්තනය ඉගෙන ගත්තේ. ඉතින් ඉන්දියාවේ ගිහිල්ලත් මට මේ මම හරි සන්තෝෂයි කියන්නේ මං හරි වෙලාවේ හරි තැනට ගිහින් හිටියා. ඒ කියන්නේ දැන් මම ගිහින් කේරළේ කලා මණ්ඩලයේ ඉගෙන ගත්තා නම් එතකොට කතකාලි හරි දැන් කියමුකෝ මේ ටාන්ජෝර් වල ඉගෙන ගත්තා නම් බර්තන් දැන් මම ගියේ මම ඉගෙන ගත්තේ මේ ඒ ආයතන වල කියන්නේ අනිත් හැම කලාවක්ම ඒගොල්ලෝ ඉගෙනවා. ඒතර චිත්‍ර කලාව, මූර්ති කලාව, ඒතර සංගීතය මේ හැම එකක්ම ආශ්‍රයෙන් ඒව පෝෂණය ඒ පෝෂණය ලබාගෙන තමයි මම ඉගෙන ගත්තේ. ඉතින් ඒ නිසා තමයි මම හිතුවේ දැන් ඒ දැන් මේ අලුත් තරුණ මේ අපේ තරුණ පිරිස ගත්තාම ඒගොල්ලෝ සංගීතය නම් සංගීතය විතරයි කරන්නේ, නර්තනය නම් නර්තනය විතරයි. ඒගොල්ලෝ මේ නාට්‍යකරණය කරනවා නම් ඒගොල්ලෝ ඉගෙන ගන්නවා දෙක තුනෙන්ම නමුත් අර හරි පදනමක් වැටෙන්න. ඉතින් ඒගොල්ලන්ට හරි පදනමක් දෙන්න තමයි අපි මේ කතා කරලා තීරණය කෙරුවේ මේ අමියනේ පියවරක් අරගෙන ඉදිරියට යන්න.